Hi, my name's Tafina. Welcome back to my channel. If you are not new, if you guys are new, welcome to my channel for the first time. Hello. But today what I want to do is I want to talk about my wedding. So this is something I've been wanting to do for a while now, and I know on my previous vlogs I told you guys, like, I'm getting married and I'm in the process of planning, I'm doing this, I'm doing that, yada yada. Alright, so basically I did get married. I got married to a wonderful guy named Cortland and married a lot of balls and chain. I'm just kidding. Yeah, so I did get married back in October of 2019, and I'm just now doing a video about my wedding. But what I'm gonna do before I actually start talking about my wedding is I'm going to do, hold on, sorry, my bra strap's irritating me. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to get some snacks, and then it's not, I don't know if it's a mukbang, I'm just going to snack away and talk about it at the same time. So here's my snacks. I got an Arizona sweet tea, so we're going to be sipping on this, and I got a bag of Gardettos, so this is what we're going to eat and drink at the same time while we're talking about my wedding. And also, I also want to mention that I have Daisy, Zuzu, and Kilo running around. So if you guys hear like little thumps or like walking and like that, it's their nails. They're walking around, chasing each other, wrestling in the background. But we have wooden tile floor, so their nails are hitting the floor. There's Kilo, my little gato. Go play. So first of all, is I want to address my voice. I just got over a cold. I'm waiting for my voice to like officially come back. So right now it sounds all like squeaky and ugly, and I'm sorry about that. Oh, and I have this ugly like dry cough that just won't go away just yet. But anyways, excuse me for that. So let's start from the beginning. So Quara and I, we had planned on, when we first got engaged and stuff, we had planned on doing like this big old wedding, renting like a reception hall. Hold on, I have the TV on in the background. We decided to like rent this big old reception hall. We're going to have like family, friends there. We're going to do like the big old church. We're going to go from the church to the reception hall. We're going to hire a DJ. We're going to pay for like this big old lavish thing. That was our plan when we first started. But then Corlin, he was just like, I'm not really into this wedding planning thing. And he was like, you just plan it. You tell me what I have to pay for. Tell me where to be, when to be, what to wear. And he's like, I'll show up. And he's like, you have to do everything on your own. I was like, all right, fine. So I told him, I was like, I don't mind doing that. And then, well, it was actually a big piece, sorry. And then, so I told him, I was like, yeah, that's fine, I can do it. And so that was our plans. I started going around with like friends and stuff, and we're looking at like reception halls. We were looking at churches. We were doing like the big old wedding planning. Like I wanted it big. So we start doing that, and then we're like, it's gonna be like 3,000, 4,000. And I was like, fine, whatever. I want it. I'm getting married. It's a one time thing. And then, so we were doing that. I had five groomsmen, five bridesmaids, flower girl, two ring boys. Our colors were, We were going back and forth between teal and turquoise, and that was our colors, and that was our plan. And we started doing all that planning. We started paying for like the caterers. We paid for the caterers. We paid for the DJ. We put a deposit down to hold a reception hall for us. We started paying for stuff, and then later on in the year, come to find out, I actually had to have surgery. And with me going into surgery and stuff, I had to work it out with my work to where I was going to be out of work for at least up to a month. And then with me being out of work for at least up to a month, I wasn't getting an income. And we already paid for stuff, but then at the same time, like, I didn't want to be struggling with bills. I didn't want to be trying to live paycheck to paycheck to make ends meet. And that's what I didn't want to do. So then we just put the wedding and everything on pause. And then I had my surgery. And then during that time frame, like, we didn't pay attention to the wedding. We didn't do any planning. We didn't... we just stopped everything wedding in general. And then as I got closer to the end of my vacation and stuff, I started looking into the wedding and everything again. I was like, we still have to pay for this, we still have to pay for that. And with me not having an income, I was barely getting anything from my leave. I mean, I still got a percentage of what my normal pay would be, but it wasn't like a lot. So then Coral and I talked about it, and we're just like, what if we just cancel the big old wedding thing that we wanted and do something a lot smaller or not as expensive? So I was like, all right, that's fine. I don't mind that. So we got a refund on everything. We got all of our money back from our deposits. Everything we paid for so far. We got all of that money back. And then... oh, that was loud. So, once we got all of the money back, we started looking at other ideas on how to still have a wedding but not be broke. And then, so, one day, I was at home, was looking on Pinterest, and I, like, searched up, wedding ideas for inexpensive way or something like that. And I was looking on there, and then I came across one where one lady, what are you crying for? Sorry, Daisy's crying. What do you want, baby? Lay up here by Zuzu. Lay down. Up. Lay down. Sorry. The babies were crying. My babies. My fur babies. I was looking on Pinterest, and I was looking at ideas and like ways that people went for their wedding for inexpensive ways. And then I came across one lady. She posted like on her board her wedding ideas, and I was like looking into it, and she rented an Airbnb, and then they just had the wedding stuff there. And I was like, that's interesting. So that intrigued me, and I brought it to Cortland's attention, and I was like, what if we just did an Airbnb, just had the wedding in the backyard? And he was just like, yeah. And he was like, how much would it cost? And I was like, I don't know. So what I did is I downloaded the Airbnb app, and then I started looking for houses here in the valley, and I came across some like really, really pretty houses. And then I started messaging like the owner or their hostess, and I started asking them, like, would you be okay with a wedding being at your house and for this many people? And then a lot of them got back to me right away, and they were just like, Yeah, you can have a wedding at our house, but then you have to pay for the house, you have to pay the fees, you have to do an liability insurance, you have to pay a $50 deposit for every person. You have to do a cleaning deposit, a grass deposit, a deposit deposit. And I was just like, oh my gosh, it's a lot. And I thought it was gonna be something simple, and they're just like, no. And I'm like, okay. Not no, but they're just like deposit, deposit, deposit. And I was, it just started racking up. And by the time at the end, it just like the bill was just around what it would be if we had just gotten the reception hall and all that stuff. And I was like, I don't know. So then I reached out to one guy and he got back to me. I think it was the next day. And then he was like, yeah, you can have a wedding at my house. I don't mind. And I asked him, I was like, well, what all comes with it? Like the deposits, is there any other fees? And he was like, no. He's like, all you have to do is just pay for your stay there. And then just make sure that when you leave, that you leave the house as it is when you came. Make sure you don't break anything. Clean up after yourself. Clean up after in the backyard and stuff. And I was just like, really? No fees, like no deposits for cleaning, no deposits for grass. And he was just like, no. He's like, just clean up after yourself, pay for the rental, and then you're good. And then I talked to Coraline, and Coraline's like, yeah, let's do it. So then we end up paying for the house for 3 days. So we got married on a Sunday. And that were that so the Sunday that we got married was the 9 year date that we have been together, exactly 9 years. So we don't have two separate anniversaries. We have one anniversary where it worked out for us. And so for the 3 nights we paid all together, it was a total of like between $430 and $500. I'm not really sure. I know it was that much in between there. I think it was like 460. I could be wrong. But anyways, it was within that price range for the whole time, for the entire stay. So we paid it, and then Cortland's sister had like this brand new canopy. It was so pretty. It was like really, really long. It was white, and it was like, you know how like canopies are like square? This one was like a rectangle one, really long. So we asked her if we can borrow, and she was like, yeah, that's fine. We rented some not trailers, some chairs. We rented some chairs. And then we spent like $40 on 30 chairs. And then what we did was we just put it up in the backyard and just lined up the chairs. The house that we got, it was a one-story house, but it was a big house. It had like two living rooms. It had a walk-in. When you walk into the house, there's a living room right there. There's a living room. When you walk further in, there's a big kitchen. It had like four bedrooms, a master bedroom that Cortland and I stayed in, which was big, big. Oh, excuse me. And it had like a little den area that he converted into like a bedroom area. The only thing is it didn't have a door. So there was that area. And then he had like, when you first walk in to the house, there was like a living room right there. And then he had this big old couch that if you just push the sectional part to it, no, the footrest part to it, it would turn into a bed basically. So it was really big. And so in the end, we had like a lot of space to work with. And we were asking people, why do you need a place to stay? You can stay with us. And people were just like, yeah, we'll stay with you. And we asked them like, well, if you're gonna stay with us, you have to pitch in this much, and then you can just stay there for the 3 days. And so we told them just pay this much, and then you can stay with us. And but then what we didn't tell them was, Well, we said, just pay us when you get to the house. And then they were like, okay, yeah, that's fine. But what we didn't tell them was, when they were going to hand us the money, we're just going to be like, oh no, you can go ahead and keep it. We're just saying that just so that way you guys can have an extra amount of spending money. And then, so we did that. And then we just told them, like, you just keep the money. I mean, we're not going to have people pay to stay with us. We just wanted to trick them. And then after that, so we got to check into the house on Saturday. And then on Saturday, we were at the house. We started bringing stuff over. We started like getting situated, started preparing things, set up the canopy, and we did all of that. And then people that were going to stay at the house, they started showing up and they helped us. We just had like a dinner and stuff in the evening time, spaghetti, and we were just laughing. And then by the time we did all the running around that day, Cortland and I were just so tired. We had to go back and forth between stores, order the food. We had to do like last minute little things. And so we did that. We went to go get our dogs. It was a lot. So by the time we had like the dinner and the Saturday before our wedding, we had the spaghetti and we were just like done. We were so tired and people were like, let's go drink. And we were just like, we're tired. And then we had like one, it was like, all right, I'm done. I can't, I'm sleepy. I just want to go to bed. So we went to bed. Sunday morning, we woke up to like a lot of messages and people were just like, oh, we made it to the valley. We're here. We're excited to see you guys tomorrow. And then I woke up early. We woke up early. We showered. We started getting ready. And then we started making the cake. So basically for our wedding, what we did is we didn't do anything extravagant food-wise. Sorry, bitches. So we didn't do anything extravagant. So basically what Coral and I did for our wedding cake was we just bought like those in the grocery store, like the ones you just buy off the counter or the shelf. And then we just baked it. And then we just got carrot cake. And we just got, all together, we spent like $6 on our wedding cake. So we were super cheap. And then we did that. We were making the cake. And then the guys, they went to go pick up the food that we ordered. And then just do like some last minute stuff in the morning. So that's what they did. And then people started, Cortland's aunt showed up and she was just like, what do you guys need to do? What do you guys need done still? And we told her, like, we still gotta do this, we gotta do that, we gotta do this. And she was just like, you guys just let me know what you still need to get done and then I'll do it. Then you guys can go get ready. And we're like, really? She's like, yeah. So we gave her a list of stuff and then we designated certain things that still needed to be completed with whoever was already at the house and like willing to help out. So we told them, like, do this, do that. And then they're just like, all right. And then Coral and I just started going, we went back into the room to start getting ready. And then we started getting ready. People started showing up. People were like, what else needs to be done? What else needs to be done? And then, so a lot of people started showing up. Cortland's family, my family. And then they were just all running around, making sure everything was done. And so our ring boys showed up. My grandbabies, Josiah and Eli. And then they're just all hanging out. People were just conversating, interacting with each other. Cortland's family, my family, they were just talking. All the aunts, Cortland's aunties, they were all getting the food and everything ready. And so what we did for our food was we just ordered two of the big old 6-inch sub sandwiches from Fry's. That's all we did. We asked people, like, can you bring chips? Can you bring soda? Can you bring water? People brought, like, sides like pasta salad, cookies, like finger food, and they brought, like, sides. So, all together, Carl and I, the only thing we paid for food wise was our cake and some alcoholic beverages after. So, that's all we paid for. Everybody else contributed. Somebody paid for the subs, somebody paid for the other subs, somebody paid for the chips, the water, the soda, the juice. They brought the sides. Like, our family literally helped us pay for all of that. And they're just like, do you need anything? And we're like, well, could you pay for this? Could you pay for that? Could you bring this? And they're like, yeah. And like, we didn't get any pushback from anybody. They're just like, yeah, just let us know what you need and we'll do it. So we're like, all right. So that really helped us a lot financially and physically. So they're all in the kitchen getting things ready. And then Coral and I were done getting ready. We walked out of the bedroom and so our colors were turquoise and black. So I just got like a simple black tutu skirt from Amazon, which was like $7. Just a turquoise shirt that was like a quarter sleeves right here. It was just all turquoise. And my grandbabies, they got like turquoise button up and black pants. Corlin's niece, she had like a turquoise dress already, so that's all we wore. And then my friend Lena, she made the flowers for us, like the boutonniere, the bouquet, and they're really pretty. And she just did like a turquoise tealish color, and she made those for us, and it was so simple, right to the point. And we didn't have any groomsmen or bridesmaids because we asked them, like, did you guys get your stuff? They were like, no. And we're like, all right, don't worry about it. We're not going to use you guys, not to be mean. But since we downgraded our wedding, we don't need that big old thing. They're like, yeah, that's fine, that's fine. But they all still showed up to our wedding. And then they all, a lot of people are showing up, but it was a lot of people in that house. But thank God it was a big house, so it wasn't like suffocating. And then in the backyard, we had it was a pretty big backyard. There was a swimming pool. There was like a bar, not a bar, a barbecue pit area. We had like outside patio tables and chairs. And then we had like this big old grass area that we put the canopy on top of. Then we put the chairs out and we just like put them in diagonal. And so that's our wedding set. And then we had people getting the music ready that we wanted to walk out to. And yeah, it was nice, really, really nice. And so then when we came out of the room, we were just interacting with people, just saying hi, shaking hands, and just being like, oh, hey, thank you for showing up and all that stuff. And then while we're waiting, we're just conversating and everything, we're waiting for our flower girl to show up, which is Cortland's niece, Cheyenne. And we're waiting for his sister to show up, and everybody was calling and calling her. She wasn't answering. And it was like almost 30 minutes past the time where our wedding was supposed to start, and we're just like, where are they at? Where are they at? Hold on. The plane's going by. Okay. I live right, not right close. I live close to Luke Air Force Base, so you can hear the planes and the jets and stuff. But anyways, so what happened was we were just waiting for them to show up. They weren't answering. And then my niece, who is my niece has a daughter, and we're already using her two boys, Josiah and Eli, as our ring boys, and those are my grandbabies. So then she has a daughter. Her name's Alicia. So we asked her, we're like, can we use Alicia as our flower girl instead? And she's like, yeah, that's fine. Because she already had like a turquoise blue dress on already. So we're just like, can we just use her? And she's like, yeah, that's fine. So then I just end up using three of my grandbabies. Two ring boys and a flower girl. And then we just got everybody outside, and then everybody's sitting down, and then we start the wedding. We started the procession. They were all walking out and everything. And then the person who officiated our wedding is my pastor. It's Pastor Limbert Curtis. He's from Bird Springs, Arizona, and then his church is Skylight Ministries. So he really drove all the way down from up north, or drove from up north, which is like a 3.5-hour drive, and he officiated our wedding. And I'm so thankful, because I really wanted him to be the one to marry us. His family and my family, we all know each other. It's my mom, my dad, his mom, his dad. It's just like a huge family friend thing. So we've known him for years. Well, we got down the aisle and everything, and then he was marrying us, and started the ceremony. And at that time, Cortland's niece showed up, and it was a little too late. And I was like, oh man, because she really wanted to be our flower girl. I felt bad. But then we ended up getting married and stuff without, well, I mean, they were present, but we didn't use her. And then it's so funny, because when my pastor, he was like, I just want to introduce you guys to Mr. and Mrs. Cortland. And then he stuttered on Cortland's last name. Cortland's last name is Ed City. And then he was like, Cortland's, and then it was so funny when he was stuttering and all of the Mr. and Mrs. Cortland Cabinto. Everybody just started laughing, because Cabinto is my maiden last name. And then yeah, so that was our wedding, and then we went back inside, we were taking pictures, we were like, everybody's like, congratulations, we signed the marriage license, everybody started eating, and then everybody was just like conversating, just hanging out and all of that, and then we were just hanging out, and when we were done eating, we ended up doing the cake. We did the cake. It was just like the simple, like this big, and it was like this thick carrot cake. And remember, I told you, it's the one we just bought at the store, grocery store, which is like $1 something. And then, so we did that. And then we just fed it to each other. We thanked everybody for coming. We had the prayer and Christian way. We had the prayer in traditional way, because Cortland's family, they're traditional. So then we did the water passing and all of that. They blessed the water. And then after that, what happened after that? Oh yeah, we just thanked people for coming. And then some people, they just hung around. Some people were leaving. And then we just started cleaning up. And then after a lot of the people left, there was just like us, our friends, some family members that are around our age. We had co-workers there. We had friends show up. And then we were just like, all right, now time to party. So we just started hanging out. We started drinking. We started doing shots. We were just laughing, drinking, cooking. We bought food for the evening time when we're going to hang out after our wedding. We started to grill, and the guys are throwing each other in the pool. And then my cousins and I were just laughing. My friends were just all sitting there laughing with the guys. And I don't know why, but all the guys went in one area and they're just hanging out. And then all the girls are on this side. But it was so much fun. And then people just end up sleeping over, people left, and then we woke up early the next day, we started cleaning, and then we left. So that's really it. That's our simple wedding story. Like, we didn't do anything extra. We just kept it low-key, very simple, and we enjoyed it. I mean, I love my wedding. It sounds really, really simple. It may not sound extravagant. It may sound like low budget, which it really was what we, which it really was what we wanted to try to do, was keep it low budget and not expensive or break our bank accounts. But yeah, my wedding, I loved it so much because it's something that we wanted to do. It was something that we knew that we would enjoy, that we would love. We didn't have to do anything extra to make it fun for Corlin and I, because that was our main focus, was to make sure that him and I both enjoyed and had fun. Other people's opinions we didn't really care for. And we didn't really take it into consideration because it was our day. And, but yeah, that's our wedding story. And then it was so much fun. And I love the guy that I'm married to. He's such a hard worker. He's one of a kind. He's just the best person that I'm happy that I married. But yeah. Anyways, I really hope you guys did enjoy this video. Listening to me talk, listening to me rant, and then even putting up with my voice and how ugly it sounds. And I do hope you guys did enjoy some of what I was saying. I also wanted to let you guys know that I didn't do any vlogging on my wedding. I didn't want to vlog and take out of my day with spending time with my family, my friends, and people that are close to me and that we love. I didn't want to ask someone to vlog for me because I didn't want to take away from their time and their enjoyment. And, but I do have a lot of pictures, which I'll definitely insert here. And yeah, I'm just so happy. Just thinking about all of this and talking about my wedding, it just brings back like a lot of memories. And it just brings back like a smile to my face, and I love it. I love my wedding. Yeah. But anyways, before I let you guys go, I just want to say thank you guys so much for taking the time to watch this video, taking the time to listen to me. If you guys have any questions or want to know what we did in our wedding, like if I didn't go over something, just ask me in the comments down below. If you have any questions about how we went about our wedding, just ask me. I don't mind. And then, but yeah, but like I said, just thank you guys for watching. If you guys would like to, you guys can like and comment on this video. But if you're not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. I would really appreciate it. Other than that, I do hope you guys have a great day and enjoy the rest of your day. So now I'll be entering in the pictures from my wedding. I think I might have some clips from Snapchat, but we'll see if I can find them. But anyways, thank you for watching. Have a good day. Bye. did again, damn it.
Look at Daisy, look at Daisy. Daisy's getting mashed.